From UNICEF, Madame Zaman, but also the President Editors Guild. Allow me also to recognize the Press Club, other key stakeholders in this forum, but in particular also the Parent Association, which is led by Nicholas Mayu, but I also saw Major Nyakundi here. From the religious fraternity, as you know, we hold dear our children. And as many of you may have known or gone through in our religious places of worship, from our childhood we have different formations. And I know from the Christians we have the Sunday schools where we take through our children through training on spirituality and how they should grow. Also from the Muslims we do have madrasas where children are also taken care of. But again above that we do have you know, also education institutions that are really run by the religious fraternity. This discourse is very, very key, as one of us alluded earlier, because we are talking of the future. If we do not set a good foundation for our future, then we are doomed to perish. And therefore, our coming together is very key, and it is important to gather to see how we answer to Dr. Koriro's questions, but also to what our governor also alluded to, but even also our guest speaker. It is not an easy task. We've seen our children go through so much at the onset of the 9 months when even the religious places of worship were closed, and no one was ready even to host their own children in their own homes. Parents had to work on how to go about it. It's a moment where we have learned there are a lot of gaps in parenting, and you will bear with me that together we need to walk this journey, and there is need for us to continue coming together for such discourse. I want to pray that we continue to speak to our children as we encourage them to go back to school, despite the challenges that we may, the myriad challenges that we may have. Let's have our children go back to school. We've seen the much disadvantages that we've seen when they were out there in the streets, in the community. There has been a lot that our children have gone through. They have learned so very many, even allow me to say, bad things. We've seen increase in drug abuse. You've seen the cases of pregnancy. You know, a number of issues that have emerged, which actually justify our need to work together as a community in trying to see how our children grow in terms of morality. Allow me to echo the sentiments of UNICEF that we need to see our children go back to school in a safe way. But allow me also to say this. We are seeing countries that are going back, like Rwanda, they are closing schools. Nigeria is all, I hear such a discourse. I think we need to urge the ministry to be very, very careful in terms of monitoring so that we do have adequate support, but also mechanisms to make sure that we evade any infections that may arise from our learning institutions. Religious leaders are key to support this move, and allow me to request each one of us to come on board and let's move as a family. Sorry and apologies for Dr. Kuria, who was with us. He could not continue. We are hosting the Africa Council of Religious Leaders around, and he's the CEO also of for the Africa Council. Thank you so very much for listening to me.
Thank you, Father Boutier. The next person, I'm opening this for plenary, will